Today, we will see about thyroid disorders, a group of common conditions which will be affecting thyroid gland. There will be set of conditions which will be affecting as a result of the thyroid gland impairment, any kind of dysfunctioning of thyroid gland impairment, these conditions will be arising. So in this part, we will see mainly general introduction to those set of conditions, along with causes and pathology of thyroid disorders. Myself, Dr. Anandas, Assistant Professor, Department of Roganidana Evam Vigruti Vijnana, Global Institute of Ayurveda, Rajkot. So before going with the conditions, this much set of symptoms you can see under thyroid disorders. So whenever we will discuss about thyroid disorders, it will not be coined with a single term. Under the thyroid disorders, under the umbrella of thyroid disorders, this many conditions are commonly seen. Hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, Hashimoto's disease, Graves' disease, thyrotoxicosis. So separately, if we see or if we look into each part, it will be specified with the specific features. But whenever we will see in detail about each situations, one will be the cause for another condition. So at same time, this will be exist as unique in nature. Meantime, it will be cause for manifestation of another condition. So both are interlinked in nature, because within these five terms, all terms are interlinked in nature. We will see in detail about these conditions in general introduction. With the conditions, general anatomy of thyroid and parathyroid glands, as we all know, from the front view, and thyroid gland consists of right lobe and the left lobe, which will be connected with a common junction called isthmus, which in the, will be seen in the front view of a thyroid gland. Just before or just in the back side of the thyroid gland, as I take a back view, we can see four pair of parathyroid glands, which will be situating the just back side to the two lobes. So it will be oppositely situating thyroid glands and the parathyroid glands. We will see about each terms which we have seen already in general introduction portion. First of all, Hashimoto's disease or Hashimoto's thyroiditis. What does it mean? Hashimoto's thyroiditis, also known as chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis and Hashimoto's disease. So within these three terms are there for Hashimoto's thyroiditis condition: Hashimoto's thyroiditis, chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis, and Hashimoto's disease. It's an autoimmune disease in which the thyroid gland is gradually destroyed. So the autoimmune system which is present in our body will be causing the destruction of thyroid gland. So within our body, the autoimmune system will be act against or antagonistically acting towards the thyroid gland. So because of that antagonistic action or that fight action, what will be causing? Thyroid gland will be getting destroyed. That is Hashimoto's thyroiditis or chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis or Hashimoto's disease, an autoimmune disease. Hashimoto's thyroiditis or chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis is an autoimmune disorder that causes inflammation of the thyroid gland. So whenever there will be any kind of a destruction, any kind of dysfunctioning which will be causing to an organism or a gland, that will act or behave like impairment, which will be causing its proper functionings will be getting hampered totally. So in case of Hashimoto's thyroiditis, what will be happening? As in the infectious condition, what will be causing? It's an autoimmune disorder which will be causing inflammation of the thyroid gland. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is the most common cause of hypothyroidism, which means low thyroid hormone levels in the blood. So hypothyroidism is constituted with the condition of in our blood there will be low thyroid hormone presence. So Hashimoto's thyroiditis is the most common cause of hypothyroidism. Nothing but hypothyroidism is caused by Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Symptoms of Hashimoto's thyroiditis are the same as hypothyroidism, like a weight gain, feeling tiredness of body, constipation, depression, and general pains. So as we have already seen in introduction stuff, I have told you, these terms or these conditions will be interlinked in nature. There is some certain connection with respect to these terms. So Hashimoto's thyroiditis is nothing but it's a unique term, but it's a cause for hypothyroidism. Because of that connection or because of the relation or mutual relation, what does it show? In case of Hashimoto's thyroiditis, we can expect the same symptoms as of hypothyroidism. So what are the symptoms we can expect in hypothyroidism? That much set of symptoms we can expect in case of Hashimoto's thyroiditis also. Graves' disease. Graves' disease is an immune system disorder that results in the overproduction of thyroid hormones. Wherever in condition of Graves' disease, what does it show? In this case, with respect to an immune, this is also an immune system related disorder only. Here what will be happening? There will be overproduction of the thyroid hormones as a result of impairment of the thyroid gland. The thyroid hormones will be getting produced more than adequate quantity. Certain limitations are there, certain limit is there for the proper production or for the proper need of a thyroid hormone to the body. If it exceeds more, it will affect our body adversely. So Graves' disease is a common cause of hyperthyroidism. So hyperthyroidism is nothing but in our body there will be increased amount of thyroid hormone. As an overproduction of a thyroid gland, what will be happening? There will be increased amount of thyroid presence of thyroid hormone in our body. So Graves' disease is a common cause of hyperthyroidism. Because of that, signs and symptoms of Graves' disease are the same as hyperthyroidism, including irritability, muscle weakness, sleeping problems, fast heartbeat, poor tolerance of heat, diarrhea, and unintentional weight loss. So because of this condition or because of this mutual relationship or that interlinking, what we can expect? Symptoms which we can expect in condition of hyperthyroidism, that set of symptoms we can also expect in situation of Graves' disease also. So you should understand with the interlinking between Hashimoto's thyroiditis and hypothyroidism. Here Graves' disease with respect to hyperthyroidism. Next, thyrotoxicosis. Thyrotoxicosis is the condition that occurs due to excessive thyroid hormone of any cause and therefore includes hyperthyroidism. So here also the condition called thyrotoxicosis will be including or will be considered under hyperthyroidism situation only. Why? Because the clinical feature or the cardinal symptom of thyrotoxicosis, which we can expect in our body, increased amount of or excessive thyroid hormonally. The causes will be n number of causes will be there. There will not be a specular cause. There will be n number of causes, but it will be depend upon that situation. Because of any cause, that's why it is not mentioned here. Because of any systemic causes or any kind of conditions, there will be increased amount of thyroid hormone in our blood or in the patient's blood. So because of that condition, wherever there will be increased amount of thyroxin or thyroid hormone, that will be concluding with the condition of hyperthyroidism. So here also what is happening? Excessive thyroid hormone secretion will be happening, or excessive secretion of thyroxin. Thyroxin is nothing but thyroid hormone only. That will be happening because of some certain causes or because of any causes. That's why it's including under hyperthyroidism. It means that condition of low level of thyroid stimulating hormone TSH in bloodstream, because the pituitary gland senses that you have enough thyroid hormone. Here it's impairing with the normal reflex functions or normal signaling of the hypothalamus with which respect to proper production of thyroid hormones. Wherever there will be the low condition where the condition of low level of thyroid stimulating hormone in bloodstream. Why? Because the pituitary gland will be senses that you have enough thyroid hormone. So with respect to any kind of defect with respect to that reflexing system, which will be enabling with the pituitary gland, thereby get connected with the signaling. So that defect will be causing further production of thyroid hormone. Why? Because low level of thyroid stimulating hormone, TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone will be in low level. Why? Because pituitary gland will always will signaling with the condition we have enough thyroid hormone. Why? Because that there will be thyroid stimulating hormone will be very low in nature. Hyperthyroidism, also referred to as an overactive thyroid, is the most common cause of thyrotoxicosis. So among several causes, here it is told that for the condition of thyrotoxicosis, hyperactivity of a thyroid gland will be the primary causes for thyrotoxicosis. And it occurs when thyroid gland produces too much thyroid hormone. The most common cause of hyperthyroidism is Graves' disease. So again, we can interlink with this condition to Graves' disease. Why? Because Graves' disease is conjoined with the situation of hyperthyroidism. In Graves' disease also, we have already seen there will be excessive production of thyroid hormone. But here with respect to thyrotoxicosis, and among the causes that will be hyperthyroidism only, which will be leading to the thyrotoxicosis condition. And there will be always the abnormal sensing or sensory reflex will be produced by the pituitary gland that we have enough thyroid hormone. Because of that, there will be low level of thyroid stimulating hormone. So generally, we will conclude regarding a general introduction of hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. Hypothyroidism, also called underactive thyroid or low thyroid, is a disorder of the endocrine system in which the thyroid gland does not produce enough thyroid hormone. So in condition of hypothyroidism, there will be inadequate production of thyroid toxin hormone. In case of hyperthyroidism, hyperthyroidism is the condition that occurs due to excessive production of thyroid hormones by the thyroid gland. There will be excessive production of thyroid hormone or thyroxine. Thyrotoxicosis is the condition that occurs due to excessive thyroid hormone of any cause and therefore includes under hyperthyroidism. This was regarding the general introduction to different conditions or different situations will be aligning under thyroid disorders. See some general causes here. Why it is happening? The causes are Hashimoto's thyroiditis, first cause. Any kind of surgical impairment with respect to the thyroid gland, with respect to any other endocrine gland, it will be connected with any kind of impairment to the particular gland. Most of the cases, it will be connected to surgical defect to the thyroid gland only. Radiation, more exposure with the radiation. For people who are working with respect to the occupational history, occupational background, there will be any kind of conditions with respect to more exposure with the radiation. Or people who live besides the situations or around the area where more radiation is emitting from industrial regions and all. Usage of some drugs which will be acting antagonistically to our body, or as a result of complications of some drugs which the patient has been used for any some other medical causes. Iodine deficiency or any kind of iodine implement which will be ended up with any kind of complicative sites. Pituitary gland problems. With respect to the pituitary gland, there will be proper signaling, proper emission of the signals, proper controlling of the release, and proper conditions will be aligned by pituitary gland only. Because of any kind of problems happening with the pituitary gland, that will be affecting proper release and proper conveying of the signals to the brain with respect to the release of the hormones, thereby causing deficiency or overproduction of thyroxine hormone. Which are the general causes which we can see for hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. Here we will see, especially for hypothyroidism, what will be the causes. First of all, iodine deficiency in diet. That is the main peculiar one among the peculiar situation, iodine deficiency in the diet. Whatever type food we are taking, any kind of deficiency is present. That will be one among the most cause. Inflammatory process of tissues of thyroid, any kind of inflammation as a result of infection happening to the tissues of thyroid gland. Complete or partial removal of thyroid gland. Surgical impairment. Unfavorable environmental factors, which will be including under radioactive radiation, exposure with radiation, work in harmful production areas or industries, which will be emitting with, where getting a continuous contact with the radiation and all, that will be one cause. Anomalies in the intrauterine development itself of the organs of endocrine system. So with respect to any kind of a defect to the endocrine system within intrauterine development of the baby, it will be preceding the situation of a hypothyroidism. The use of radioactive iodine for therapeutic purposes, that will be causing one another side effective view to the body. Drug therapy depressing thyroid function. Any kind of drug therapy, if at all the patient is undergoing for any kind of treatment or as a result of side effects or some other drugs, which will be cause for unattractive thyroid functioning. Damage and inflammation of the hypothalamus, wherever there will be influencing or any kind of hampering to the hypothalamus and its signaling and its functioning, proper maintaining, that will be causing hypothyroidism. Process of hyperthyroidism, here also injury to the thyroid gland, some kind of medications and its side effects. Hereditary, most of the conditions will be seen throughout the family history through genetic predisposition. Inflammation of the thyroid gland as a result of infection. Different hormonal changes at the type of miscarriage when a woman, pregnancy time, irregular sex life, and with respect to the menopausal situations, worsening conditions of the females, it will be seen hyperthyroidism situation. Damage to the pituitary gland, any kind of infectious diseases, and severe nerve shocks will be causing excessive production of the hyperthyroxine hormone, which will be causing hyperthyroidism. Pathology of thyroid disorders. And when we will deal with the pathology of thyroid, there will be certain conditions or certain normal alignment, which will be enabling with the normal production or normal utilization of iodine, along with the T3, T4 levels we have to discuss. So synthesis of thyroid hormones will be first of all. With respect to the trapping of iodine along with the plasma iodine and oxidation of iodine, with respect to an iodine hormone, for T3 and T4, there will be certain biochemical recipients in order to go with further production of the thyroid hormone. So plasma iodine, which is already present in the blood, trapping of the iodine, oxidation of the iodine, this must three steps continuously or consecutively happening together, along with iodination of tyrosine in thyroid gland to form monoiodine tyrosine and diiodothyrosine. So with respect to these two components, MIT and DAT, monoiodothyrosine and diiodothyrosine, it will constitute with the further iodination of the tyrosine whenever it will be properly or adequately embedded with the tyrosine content as a result of oxidation of the iodate component. This will cause coupling to form T4 and T3. Whenever there will be proper trapping along with oxidation, tyrosine content will be getting enabled or embedded with the MIT and DAT, causing coupling, which will mean a further proper replacement with respect to T4 and T3, which will be causing with storage in thyroid gland. So whenever it will be producing accurately or adequately the T4 and T3, tyrosine, and along with triiodothyronine, thyroid hormone, triiodothyronine and tyrosine will be getting stored in thyroid gland. As a result of this, further release of T4 and T3 in the blood from the thyroid gland with respect to the signaling of the anterior pituitary gland. So whenever after release of T4 and T3 to the bloodstream, peripheral conversion of T4 to T3 will be getting happen. So whenever the triiodothyrosine, the thyroid hormone with respect to the oxidation as a result of a bioconversion, whenever it will be getting contacted with the peripheral conversation, it will be undergone for the further conversion from peripheral conversion to T4 to T3 form. This will cause further deiodinization. In the previous step, it will be going with the iodination of the tyrosine to form MIT and DAT. So So within the coupling process, within the storage process, it will be contained with the tyrosine component. But whenever it will be coming to the bloodstream level, there should be proper transformation or conversion from T4 to T3. So there will be deiodination will be happening. This deiodination will be again converted to, or again will be ended up with the plasma iodide 4. So whenever there will be removal of the iodine component from the T4, whenever after happening peripheral conversion like T4 to T3, there will not be further presence of iodine component. So what will be happening? The plasma iodide with respect to go for further trapping of iodate portion with respect to oxidation of the iodate. Again, iodination happening with respect to the coupling, and proper amount of T4 T3 will be getting stored in the thyroid gland with respect to the signaling from the hypothalamus to the as a result of thyroid regulating hormone or thyroid releasing hormone. There will be proper signaling will be collected by the anterior pituitary gland. Further release of T4 and T4 T3 will be to the bloodstream. Again, conversion will be happening. So this cycle will be continuously happening as a result of or as a purpose of synthesis of thyroid hormones. Exercise, stress, because of malnutrition, low blood glucose level, and sleep, which will be coming under the commonest other positive factors. Any kind of influence from these set of positive factors like the increased level of the exercise or increased duration of the exercise, stress level, malnutrition, glucose level will be very low in blood, then impairment with respect to sleep. This will be affects or antagonistically affect over the hypothalamus functioning. So wherever there will be any kind of dysfunctioning to the hypothalamus, this will impart over certain effect over the thyroid releasing hormone. Why? Because it is released from hypothalamus. So TRS and the thyroid releasing hormone thereby release to the anterior lobe of the pituitary, where it will be consisting with the thyroid stimulating hormone. So as a result of TRH, it will be further thyroid releasing hormone, there will be further conditioning or regulation of the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, thereby releasing thyroid stimulating hormone, causing certain signaling over thyroid gland. So as a result of that, triiodothyronine and thyroxine T3 and T4 will be produced from the anterior lobe of pituitary. From the result of the anterior lobe of pituitary signaling, which will be given by the hypothalamus, thyroid gland will be secreting these set of hormones at a time. So this will be causing raised blood levels of T4 and T3, where there will be impairment with respect to T4 and T3. This will cause, or this should be undergone for certain inhibition, thereby again limiting the production of anterior lobe of pituitary with respect to hypothalamus releasing or hypothalamus signaling. This will cause hypothyroidism situation. Again, from raised blood levels of T3 and T4, this will constitute with the use of hormones by most body cells wherever it is increased. It's a normal physiological way. This will cause lowered levels of T4 and T3 so much in level. So wherever it will be increased in manner, this will go under inhibition with respect to the action of the anterior pituitary and hypothalamus functioning. So it will be getting lowered. Of course, it will be conditioned with the condition of hypothyroidism. Whenever it will be excessively raised, it will be conditioned with the hyperthyroidism. Wherever there will be use of hormones by most of the body cells, this will getting balanced by the excessive production of the thyroxine hormone. So as a result of that, what will be happening? It will cause with lowering the levels of T4 and T3. So in order to balance this condition, again, wherever there will be a reduced or remarkable reduction of the T3 and T4, stimulation further will send to the hypothalamus. Again, the cycle will be continuing. Hypothalamus will get the signal with the thyroid releasing hormone. It will again give signal to the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. It will give final signal to the thyroid stimulating hormone. So whenever it will getting signalized with the thyroid stimulating hormone, this will impact, or this will give impact over the thyroid gland to produce T4 and T3. So wherever there will be increased level and wherever there will be decreased level, in increased level it will be most of the conditions, it will, the excessive amount of the thyroxine will be getting utilized by the body cells. As I, whenever it will be exceeds the condition, it will be further sending signal to stimulation to the hypothalamus, and that balance will be maintained there. At the same time, it will be not utilizing properly, it will cause hyperthyroidism. Excessively utilizing, there will be inadequate supply of or inadequate utilization of the cells, utilization of the hormones by the cells is not happening, that will cause decreased amount of decreased amount of thyroxine, which will be causing hypothyroidism. Here we will finish the first part of thyroid disorders. In next part, we will see about symptoms of hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism, diagnosis of thyroid disorders, and complications of thyroid disorders. Thank you.